Oxygen is fundamentally one of the most important elements to keeping life forms on Earth living. If you tried to hold your breath, you wouldn't last very long before your brain begins to automatically start you breathing again, even if you try your hardest to continue trying to hold your breath. So it's quite easy to see why both you and Mr. Stickman here should feel quite uncomfortable about the thought of being trapped in an airtight room with no way of getting out. If you were trapped in a room which was 3 meters by 3 meters by 2 meters, you'd have about 18,000 liters of air in that room, which is quite a few milk bottles. Your first concern while being trapped in this room is that you'll run out of oxygen. In our 18,000 liter room, there's only 3,750 liters of oxygen, and with every breath, you are breathing in about 105 milliliters of oxygen. So you might be thinking that we're breathing out 105 milliliters of carbon dioxide, but in fact, we're only breathing out 25 milliliters of carbon dioxide and 75 milliliters of oxygen, due to us only using about 30% of the oxygen we breathe in. So when will hypoxia, which is the lack of oxygen, begin to kick in? You would have about 3 days in this room before you begin to feel the effects of being deprived of oxygen. When the oxygen level in our room drops below 16%, you'll begin to feel the effects of hypoxia, with the early symptoms of hypoxia including feeling sick, numb, tired, and feeling quite lightheaded. From then on, you'd begin to feel quite confused, your personality might change, and you'd have a reduced level of consciousness as you slowly move your way to death. Your blood will probably go from a blue colour to a red colour when you see it through your skin too. But you shouldn't be worried about hypoxia. That will kick in after about 3 days after you've been trapped in the room. The thing which is going to be your primary issue is carbon dioxide toxicity. As you breathe out, you are expelling more carbon dioxide through your lungs and into the room. In your room, you will start with about 0.04% of the air being carbon dioxide. Even with the percentage of carbon dioxide being 1% in the air, you would begin to have symptoms. Drowsiness would begin to kick in at 1%, and at 3% you'd have an increased heart rate and blood pressure, until finally at 8% you'd be unconscious with your muscles tremoring. On your second day of being trapped in this room, you'll most likely suffer from carbon dioxide toxicity and begin to die. But those numbers rely on you being calm and not overbreathing, which would mean you'd have less time in that room until you were dead. If you wanted to keep yourself alive in that room, you'd need about 400 plants with you to keep you alive. Knowing how many you need is quite hard though, because different plants and different environmental factors can affect the rate of photosynthesis. Plants also produce different amount of oxygen depending on which part of their growing cycle they are in. So should you carry around about 1,000 plants with you just to be safe? Unless you're getting into a room with a decent water supply and sunlight, those plants aren't going to last very long. Which means you'd be better off putting a hammer in your pocket so you can smash your window and escape. By the way, this channel is now over a year old. Thank you very much for watching us, and be sure to subscribe.